Hello. So today we are going to be talking about conflict and symbolism. This presentation will help you through the conflict and symbolism in the medicine bag lesson for Edgenuity. So let's start by talking about conflict. Conflict is defined as the struggle that takes place between two opposing forces in writing. Normally, we separate conflict into two categories. It is either internal conflict, which means it's a character's internal struggle, or it's an external conflict, which means that it's a conflict between a character and some form of external force. So, within each type of conflict we do, it's either called man versus or character versus. So, for internal, it is always called character versus self. So, think about character versus self within the Diary of Anne Frank. For the most part, we were seeing Anne in these voiceovers, struggling with herself and her opinions, how she felt about things. Should she be nice to Mr. Dussel? Should she be nice to Peter? How should she handle certain situations? We saw a lot of character versus self within the Diary of Anne Frank. For external, the four key ones that you should know are character versus character, character versus nature, character versus society, and character versus technology. Now, for the examples, I understand that not all of you have read every single one, but I do know that some of you probably, once I describe each, could fit a book that you enjoy into each of these conflicts. So the first is character versus character. Okay, that is the simplest. It's when we have two characters who are pretty much fighting each other. Think about Cassie versus Lily and Jean in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. They are constantly fighting with each other. They're opposing forces. They believe two very different things, and the conflict between them happens throughout the novel. The next is character versus nature, which mostly means that a character is left to survive in nature or ha is having some sort of conflict with a natural entity. So, if you've read the book Hatchet, you know that Brian, the main character, is forced to live on his own in the wilderness after a plane crash. So, the majority of the book, as well as the sequels, are about Brian's fight with surviving in the wilderness. He has to deal with different animals and trying to figure out how to live on his own, and nature seems to be going against him throughout in the majority of the book. So character versus nature is really when a character has to try to figure out how to live on their own, mostly in a natural setting, and then there are things that are happening in nature that are against them. Things like animals, different types of weather, etc. Next is character versus society. That basically means that a character has a different opinion than what the rest of society does, and they have to try to figure out how to resolve the conflict between them. In seventh grade, the majority of you read a short story called The Lottery. In The Lottery, it's about a town who has a tradition. I'm not going to spoil it if you've read it, but basically, the main character, Tessie Hutchinson, has to go against the rest of her society. She has to fight for her, in this case, belief, against the rest of her town. Okay, and the last one I'm going to talk about today is character versus technology. This is big in a lot of dystopian fiction, and one of the biggest ones is the book The Giver. So in The Giver, Jonas, the main character, has to get the Giver's memories, and there's a lot of fight against the technology that he has to give, as well as the knowledge that he learns from that technology. So that's a very less robot-esque technology, but there are some examples of books where it is a character versus some form of technology like a robot. But if you've read The Giver is probably one of the best examples in young adult literature of character versus technology. So let's talk about symbolism. Symbolism is defined as the representing of figurative things through physical objects. Basically, that means you have a physical object like the American flag. The American flag is seen as just a flag, but we all know it represents different things. It not only represents America, but it is seen throughout the entire world as a symbol of freedom, because America was one of the first countries founded on the ideals of freedom. But also for us Americans, it's a very patriotic symbol. It shows that we are proud of our country. So the American flag is one of the best basic symbols in our culture that we see pretty much every single day. In literature, one of the best examples is The Land in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. So as you might remember from either your summer reading or from the beginning of the school year, the Logan's Land is a big topic in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. The Logans are able to have more freedom because they are not relying on paying different sharecroppers in order to survive. They aren't living off somebody else's land like the majority of the Black community in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. So the land literally provides the Logans with the ability to make their own money and not have to worry about reporting to anyone. All of the money they make off of their land, they get to keep. The land then figuratively or symbolically represents independence, because the land gives the Logans independence and freedom from others. They don't have to worry about being connected to other people financially. They have financial freedom. They have the actual freedom of not reporting to people like Mr. Granger. So the land in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry represents freedom figuratively. So think about, normally when we're dealing with symbolism, we're dealing with a literal object that is being represented for something else. The other good way to think about it is symbolism is like a Tootsie Pop. You have the exterior hard shell that is literally a lollipop, but with inside you have a different meaning. Like the Tootsie Pop is the Tootsie Roll that is in a Tootsie Pop is very different from the hard candy exterior. And that is conflict and symbolism. If you have any questions, please let me know.